is a bloom shoots up through the stony ground, but there's no room, no space to rent in this town. You're out of luck, and the reason that you had to care, the traffic is stuck.
Thank you. I would like to formally commence with the class of 2020 for their streamed online valedictory assembly. As you can see through those images, we could not be prouder of this group of 80 young adults. They are our hopes, dreamers, mechanics, tradies, performers, scientists, health workers, IT gurus, lawyers, advocates for social justice, environmental warriors, just to name a few future-minded possibilities that we've seen them be involved in, especially over the last 12 or 18 months. Most importantly, though, they are our grandchildren, foster children, our stepchildren, sons and daughters. Today, during our 2020 valedictory assembly, we will recognise their time at BDC and celebrate graduating as BDC alumni and complete this special rite of passage. We thank all parents, guardians, grandparents and extended family who have guided, loved and cared for these young adults as they complete their HSC pathway at Bishop Druitt College. We also acknowledge that unfortunately families cannot join us here live today, but we do hope that you enjoy what we present over our live stream. The assembly is now about to begin, and in 2020, we have asked the class of 2020 to dress up, show off, and live the moment at our graduation assembly today. Each group will make a grand entrance. They'll actually stop, have a photo moment at the door, and then they will sit with their tutor family. After their special entrance, we'll move to our acknowledgement of country and our principal and year coordinator greetings. Each tutor group will be formally acknowledged on stage and include certificates and awards. The valedictory assembly will conclude with a farewell by kindergarten. And as year 12 leave, the live stream will then finish. This will be approximately 12:45. At this time, the valedictorians will enjoy each other's company and a light lunch. Speeches by fellow students, and this will finish approximately 1:30 p.m. Now, with our range of changes due to health requirements, we have apologies from our Bishop, Dr. Murray Harvey. Our College Council would like to acknowledge one of our most prestigious days in 2020 by wishing our class of 2020 all the very best for the HSC examinations and the exciting future that lies ahead for each person. The Council is proud of this group of young people and the way in which they have adapted to this challenging year. That's on behalf of the College Council, Mr. David Ford. The Guard of Honour as they depart today will be unique and will be very special this year. I now hand you over to our 2021 Service and Leadership Captains, Ty and Mawahib. They will be our first Assembly MCs for today.
We hope that you're ready to sit back, get out your parent graduation pack and enjoy our Assembly. It is my pleasure to now introduce the Class of 2020 Tutor Teachers and College Leadership Team. Emily Cruz and Charlie Alderman. Paris Winark and Lucy Jones. Brianna Maloaf and Fergus McNeil. Quinn Allen and Alex Hill. Ali Martin and Rachel Newman. Charlotte Bell and Colby Noble. Lillian Ramond and Isaac Butler. Sarah Fair, Megan Usher and Kate Murray. Saheb Kunkun and Imogen Larry. Kodai McCuney, and Lucy Garner. Emily Pavey and Sam Parks. Shannon Beth Stafford and Jonah Bedford. Our CLT, Rachel Smith, Sarah Stokes, and Shan Oxley.
Meg Denman and Brady McGarry. Stephen Chang, Sam Goodwin, and Denver Peterson. Christian Albina and Sam Wilson. Caitlin Lastovec, Will Crow, and Angus Longworth Brown. Jesse Woodward and Edward Berger. Tom Sweeney, Angus Fitzgerald, and Josh Corey. Tutor teachers Kelly Reinhold and Brett Bennett. Blake Island, Noah Oxley, and Kyle Lang. Lily Powell, Blake Schofel, and Cassandra Bamford. Jake Kramer and Jess Cleal. Jordan Hill and Nuri Yun. Isabel Watson and Tess Parker Reynolds. Freya Lamont and Cohen Dean. Tutor teachers Deanne Rushforth and Craig Lang.
Bailey Capicoya and Kenya Willen. Caleb Ryan and Yusuf Musri. Saskia Brown and Tom O'Dell. Ebony Casagrande, Annabelle McDonald, and Georgia Henson. Anthony Abdullah and Abdullah Abdullah. Lucy Alchemade and Ebony Machim. Tutor teachers Craig Bavruggen, Claire Murphy, and Julie Bain.
Mitchell Hodges and Bianca DeJong. Gwyn Bynan and Charlie O'Grady. Luke Walker and Mackenzie Caruana. Achol Jock, Alexis Gunther and Azra Salman. Alexis is only able to join us from home today. Sam Kaywood and Biniam Tesfamariam. Matthew Yanger and Luke Peden. And CLT, Mick Clippen, Rev Cook, Nick Johnston, and Sue O'Connor.
Well, welcome, year 12, almost for the last time I can call you that. Can you just have a look around? You look fantastic. Give each other a round of applause. Woo! Yep. Quite frankly, you look amazing. It's fantastic not to see a basketball ring in sight. So you guys have dressed this up really well. So really, as we said yesterday, today's about your photo moment. So enjoy the whole assembly, your lunch, and of course, even the formality. So it's so exciting to see you here. I do have a couple of messages that we're required to give. First one is around our health and hygiene requirements, and you might notice our newest COVID, officer or man in black and blue over there. So he's going to keep an eye on everyone, but as you come up, if you'd like to hygiene with sanitizer, certainly our COVID specialist there will help you out. In all seriousness, the New South Wales Government and New South Wales Health have asked schools to remind everyone that it is the small actions that we do that can keep everyone safe. Now, our school environment has been a little different, but even today, whether it's handshakes, etc., please respect people via social distancing as required. Once again, they've said, just a reminder, if you're unwell in the future, please get tested, self-isolate. We know that hygiene matters. Wash your hands, encourage the use of a mask. At this time of year, please support the guidelines, especially about public gatherings or when you're in public venues like cafes and restaurants. And of course, many of us, our parents are business owners. Support them and the rules they need to follow. It is really up to all of us to make COVID-safe choices. With that in mind too today, as it's live streamed, just to let people know at home, at times you may not hear a music item, and that would be because of copyright and live streaming. So don't worry, your sound is probably fine. You should still see a picture. If that happens, it's because we can't live stream that particular item, that's all. Now hand you back to Ty.
I now ask Tess Parker Reynolds to our stage to deliver our acknowledgement of country.
Today, on this special day for Year 12, we acknowledge and respect the traditional lands of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people, respecting the elders of the past, present and future. We also acknowledge those who have yet to gain confirmation due to the disassociation from stolen generations and how we must strive to close the gap that has been created. We must work together as one to gain a better understanding and respect of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people, cultures and traditions.
Please stand for our school prayer. We pray together. Creator God, we ask you to bless our school. Please give us pure hearts, meek spirits and careful tongues, that in all our life and conduct, we may show that we love you and each other in deed and in truth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated.
I would now like to invite Year 12 Year Coordinator for 2020, Mr. Mick Clippen, to the stage.
How good is this? Here we are, actually able to celebrate the completion of your school life together. Yep, it may be without your parents and carers, it may be without other students and without all of your teachers, but compared to what we thought we were going to have at the start of COVID, and compared to those schools in the Northern Hemisphere, we have actually been able to celebrate pretty well, and we have much to be grateful for. Ginagay, shalom, assalamu alaikum, konnichiwa, annyeong haseyo. Good morning to staff, students, family and friends of Year 12 watching this live. Welcome to this, the final assembly for the fabulous class of 2020. It's a wonderful opportunity to recognise, to remember, congratulate, thank and say farewell to this group of young adults who have enriched this community over the years that they have been here. It all started normally enough. We had the Year 12 camp. We had the first round of assessment tasks in Term 4 last year. We had the Cambodia service trip. All pretty usual. A little bit hotter. We had a few more fires than usual. But since then, we've had a whole new language evolve. Catastrophic. Ablaze. Hottest ever. Post-apocalyptic. Unprecedented. Flattening the curve. Zoom and Google Meets, 1 in 100, R rates, and the new normal. Still not sure what that one is. Welcome to the crazy world of the class of 2020 and their Year 12 year. I'm still wondering, as no doubt many others are, whether we'll ever actually return to the old normal. Not only have you had to deal with the changes this year, but you have had little certainty about next year either. Will university still be online for you? Will you be moving to new cities to study? Will you be able to have your gap year travelling the world, as many of you want to do? And yet here we are, and time does keep rolling on. Things still happen in their due order. We've had our 18ths, trials, major works due, graduating, green peas, HSC exams, ATARs, Christmas will come along all in its due time. And what's been so impressive to me is that although some of you have struggled at times with the changes that have been wrought on you this year, you have all generally managed to keep going on. There's been ranting every so often, but mainly there has just been an acceptance that this is the reality, which to me calls to mind the wisdom of the Serenity Prayer. God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change. Courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. This then is what I see as the strength of you as a group. I have seen you being dynamic, caring, and optimistic. I have seen you being dynamic, making the most of the opportunities that have been presented in the circumstances, such as the world's greatest shave with over $13,000 raised. Incredible, massive participation in the spirit you brought to the athletics carnival. Running a fabulous Foundation Day. I've seen your optimism in the social issues that you have raised through challenging accepted societal values in areas such as stereotypes around gender and sexuality, Indigenous issues, environmental issues, and your sense that your generation will actually fight to make a better world. And I have seen numerous occasions where you have cared for each other and your teachers through being supportive, being emotionally present, giving a hug, even though not very COVID-friendly, being thoughtful and sensitive to each other's needs. And so we come to the end. For 6 years, I've had the privilege and honour, and pain at times, of watching you grow and develop from cute and daggy Year 7 kids to the delightful adults that I see before me. I remember getting letters from your parents about 6 years ago, introducing you and telling me about your excitement, your nervousness, quirkiness, shyness, ambitions, etc. And I think as we stand here on this threshold, many of those comments are probably true for you again as you move on to the next phase. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank your parents and carers for the support that they have given me over the years in working with you and the trust and commitment that they have shown in the college by sending you here. Year 12, as I look at you sitting here, so pleased with yourselves for getting this far, please know that for me personally, while I'm really excited and happy for you, this is actually a time of real sadness as well, as I farewell people that have helped me on my journey. Often, I feel that I have as much to learn from you and through our interactions as hopefully I offer to you. You remind me, given that I am often told by my society and culture class how old I am, of the vitality of being 17 or 18, and of seeing the world as a beautiful place full of hope and opportunity. I see in you the light of idealism, of love, caring and sensitivity. And happily and with gratitude, I see amongst those sitting here many hands and hearts which will work and strive for the betterment of the world in which we live. Class of 2020, you will be missed. All the best for your exams, your results, and wherever your road takes you on to. In closing, I draw a connection to some of the reflections and intentions that were shared at our excursion earlier in the week. From the poem Desiderata. And whether or not it is clear to you, no doubt the universe is unfolding as it should. Therefore, be at peace with God, whatever you conceive her to be. And whatever your labours and aspirations, in the noisy confusion of life, keep peace in your soul. With all its sham, its drudgery and broken dreams, it is still a beautiful world. Be cheerful. Strive to be happy. Year 12, thank you and congratulations.
Thank you, Mr. Clippin. I would now like to call on Mr. Johnson, our principal, to address Year 12 and families.
Kinigai, Year 12s, valedictorians. Welcome to parents, grandparents, students and staff both here and online. I welcome you to this very special day. This is a school day that you'll remember for the rest of your life because today is the last day that all of you will be in the same room at the same time. I know you've probably thought about that, but that's the reality of it. Just let the emotion of that idea wash over you for a moment. Last day. All of you in the same room at the same time. Sitting down recently to write this speech, and as I said to you earlier in the week at our Monday excursion, or was it Tuesday, I said to you, I wrote this this speech, scrapped it and wrote it again, then scrapped it, but third time lucky, you'll be pleased to know. I didn't want to focus too much on things like how our lives have changed due to COVID-19. I haven't waffled on about the new norm or remote learning or virtual assemblies or Zoom or Google Meet or even terms like live stream. I'm not even going to focus on your HSCs, which are right around the corner, as you know, so I won't. Instead, I'm going to focus on my eight life lessons, so it's not going to go too long. I've picked these up from different people in my life's journey over the years. Some are a bit more useful than others. Some might sound even a little bit flippant or comical, but let them sink in. You might come back to the eight later on and enjoy them as they go. The first one, don't be a cow. Don't judge me yet. Have you ever seen a cow on the side of the road watching cars pass by? They stare for a brief moment and then go back to chewing the grass. Nothing is really going on. They see an object, but nothing really registers. This is how some people see other people. We sort of see them, but we don't really. We're a bit like cows. We watch objects pass by, but don't really register them as humans. Seeing a person as an individual or as a subject rather than an object makes the person come alive. That's what love does. It calls things into existence. It takes time. Take the time to pause and see people for who they are. They are divine beings of incalculable significance. All of us are. Number two, choose substance over style. Great friends are people of substance. They are consistent, honest, loyal, humble, kind. Before we focus our attention on pursuing our certain lifestyles in the future, and we'll all discover those things, take a time to think about substance. I'm going to link this to fame and influence. Fame is different to influence. Fame is what you get when people know you. Influence is what you get when people believe in you. Don't aim to be famous or an influencer just for approval. Be the kind of friend who people can believe in and trust. Life is too short to settle for anything less. As you can see by what I normally wear on a day-to-day basis, I'm more about substance than style. Number three, great minds. Eleanor Roosevelt is quoted as saying, "Great minds discuss ideas, average minds discuss events, and small minds discuss people." Some people are ruled by either their insecurities or narcissism. That's unfortunate, isn't it? Because of this, though, they place too much value on short-term ambitions and strive to be noticed for any reason at all. Do not lose your peace or waste valuable time or emotional energy on people who don't enrich your life. Discuss simple and complex ideas, philosophy, strategy. Don't waste too much time in the gladiator's arena of social media or in small-minded and idle discourse. You've got great minds, use them wisely. Number four is perspective is everything. It's a bit as simple as that. With your life experience, you will develop wisdom. It takes time, it's perseverance, and it requires you to actually reflect. You will make mistakes, you will have losses, you will have challenges. Life is complex, life is messy. Some of you probably know that already. However, you have incredibly sunny days ahead of you. You'll have huge wins, you'll have amazing celebrations. In both the highs and the lows, if you can, take a deep breath. Put them in perspective, be grateful for what you have, and enjoy those ups and downs. Perspective is everything. Number five is the golden rule. Now, we're an Anglican school, so you'll know what the golden rule is. But no matter where you go, you will find people who are difficult to get along with. Managing difficult people is a massive strategic skill and enables you to live your life to its full abundance. When someone wrongs you or betrays you or acts violently towards you with physicality or in words, everything inside you will want to get them back. You'll go looking for revenge. Just remember the golden rule. It's in the Bible. It's in other places too. Leviticus 19:18. It's also quoted by Jesus of Nazareth, found in Matthew chapter 7, verse 12, Luke chapter 6, verse 31. It's described as the second great commandment. And in common English, and you would have heard these words before, do unto others as you would have them undo to you. Don't be fueled by those difficult situations. Certainly don't add fuel to that fire. Don't have those sleepless nights or be highly anxious. Instead, diffuse those misdeeds of others with forgiveness and kindness, and if you can, move on. The golden rule is in most religions. It's even an ancient Egyptian proverb that's probably about 4,500 years old at least, which says, "That which you hate to be done to you, do not do to another." The golden rule. Number six, be thoughtful, compassionate, generous, always. Some people think in order to be a good friend, you just have to be who you are and be sincere and just be yourself. While I'm not advocating deception or dishonesty, thinking only of yourself is damaging, the truth is, in order to be a great friend, you can't just be locked in your own head. The best relationships are forged in the fires of thoughtfulness, compassion, and generosity. You need to go outside yourself to find those qualities. Number seven is equity. This one is short and sweet. In the age of social media, it seems for a long time now, whoever has the most friends was the winner. Now, we're 17 and 18, and some of us a few years older than that. We all know that's not true. It's worth remembering that all people are equal, but not all opinions have the same value. Number eight, the friendship analysis. I saved this one for last. Doesn't mean it's any more important than the others, but you'll know why. There are many different and varied types of relationships. Three common ones are old friends, associate friends, and critical friends or mentors. Each of these relationships needs to be cultivated for optimum growth and well-being. Be selective in your choice of people you spend time with. As the saying goes, you cannot choose your family, sorry mums at home, but you can choose your friends. Commitment to nurturing each relationship, but also recognise its boundaries so it lifts you up and doesn't pull you down. For example, I have four what I would call critical friends or mentors. These are people that I can go to when I'm making those life-changing decisions, those strategic things, those critical decisions in your life. Things like, do I move from Western Australia to Coffs Harbour? That's a good one, a few years ago. I have five lifelong friends, people that would drop anything tomorrow and do whatever needs to be done to look after me. And I would do the same for them, and they know it. Some of these friends are childhood friends, like you'll have some of those people in the room right now. Some are people you'll meet along your life's journey. So some of mine are university friends. Some of them are family. Some of them are relatively new friends, but I knew immediately they would be lifelong friends. Some of the people around you today will fit into these different categories. Some will be critical friends, some will be mentors. Some will be lifelong friends, some will be their school friends. Only time will tell, and concerted reflection that you'll be required to do will work out where they fit. Finally, I wish to note that none of those eight things that I've been talking about today focused on stuff or possessions. They are about relationships and the people in the world around us. I was chatting last Monday with Rabbi Zalman. He was here doing some work in Grafton and Coffs Harbour. And he said to me, intercultural understanding starts first with discourse about people and with the humanity of relationships. He said that in a general conversation. Wise words indeed. I wish you well today and into the future. Remember, you are and always will have strong relationships with BDC. And today is part of your rite of passage to complete this part of your journey. You are always welcome to visit BDC into the future. This is your home and you are family. God bless Year 12. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Johnston. We will now have our recorded performance. The BDC Concert Band is playing Baba Yetta by Christopher Tin, transcribed by Matt Conaway. The recordings of our concert band were all individually made over the past few weeks due to restrictions. Please enjoy. Thank you. We would like to thank the Performing Arts Centre of Excellence for their intense support this year, especially Ms. Day, Ms. Gudgeon, Ms. Smith, and Ms. Crismell, and Hazel Buchanan. Hazel was instrumental in recording this piece today. Thank you.
Our names are Michael Spinolio and Ellie Spain, and we are the sports captains. It is my pleasure to now introduce the graduating class of CODI 2020 and their tutor teachers. Mr. Johnston has introduced a new tradition that the class of 2020 will commence today. You may have noticed that the tutor teachers are wearing white leader stoles. A graduation stole is a decorative vestment worn by students for the purpose of denoting outstanding achievements in academics. Today we wish to recognise each Year 12 student with their own class of 2020 red stoles. We will call each student alphabetically by name to accept their portfolio. Please hold your applause till the end of each house group. I now ask Mr. Craig Verbruggen and Mrs. Sue O'Connor to present CODI Year 12 with their portfolios and awards. CODI House, please line up at the stage. Abdullah Abdullah, valedictorian, tied third place in industrial technology. Anthony Abella, valedictorian, first place in construction, first place in industrial technology, effort award in English standard, effort award in business studies. Cassandra Bamford, valedictorian, third place in textiles and design. Mackenzie Caruana, valedictorian, third place in English standard, effort award in engineering studies, male swimming age champion. Jessica Cleal, valedictorian, effort award in ancient history, effort award in English standard, effort award in visual arts. Jake Kramer, valedictorian. Tom O'Dell, valedictorian, second place in software design and development, effort award for mathematics advanced, effort award in science extension one. Emily Pavey, valedictorian, second place in mathematics standard 2, effort award in economics, effort award in legal studies, effort award in drama, principal's list award, female athletics age champion. Luke Peden, valedictorian, first place in hospitality, effort award in legal studies, effort award in English standard, principal's list, and recognition on completing Southern Cross University Head Start in communication in organisations. Luke has also been notified that he will be recognised for his part in serving and protecting the community during the 2019 to 2020 bushfire emergency response. He is one of the outstanding volunteers and service personnel to be recognised for the New South Wales Department of Premier and Cabinet. We acknowledge today that Luke will be receiving a New South Wales Premier's bushfire emergency citation and a special insignia recognising his service with his local bushfire brigade. Lillian Redmond, valedictorian, tied second place in hospitality. Azra Salman, valedictorian, Third place in Italian Beginners, Effort Award in Business Studies, Effort Award in English Extension 1. Luke Walker, Valedictorian, First place in Engineering Studies, Effort Award in Mathematics Extension 2, Effort Award in Physics, Effort Award in English Advanced, Principal's List Award. Nuri Yun, Valedictorian, Third place in Japanese Continuous.
Quickly just
awesome. You've got
come
to stay
to
there
the
for
stage.
Your tutor speech, surely. Come on over. Thanks for breaking the ice. Good work.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning, parents, family and friends at home, students in classrooms, streamed live. I have had this tutor group for one term, and I've thought the whole term for what I would say at their tutor speech. I thought long and hard and decided to look up the origins of their names, and I was surprised by how much they related to their personalities. Abdullah Abdullah, meaning one with God, and Abdullah seen on camp shows his spiritual connection. He's calm, caring, always smiling member of our family. Abdullah has lived experiences that most people will never, and we're lucky to have had our lives enriched by such a gentle soul. Anthony Abella means the priceless one in Greek. This is so very true. He's priceless to our family. Anthony is our sensei. He's conquered the world, coming first in categories at the Karate US World Open Championships, but he never shouts his accomplishments to the mountains. He's incredibly modest. He is our master Miyagi and wise voice when our family needs it. Cassie Bamford, the helper of mankind is the meaning of the name Cassandra. Need I say more? Seriously, I've learnt so much from Cassie, and in my short time with the family, won't be able to learn more, but much more there is. Cassie will lead and nurture many in their future because she has an innate ability to understand the feelings of others. Mackenzie Caruana, child of the wise leader and born of fire in Scottish. Mackenzie is someone more stoic than myself, and maturity beyond his years will lift him when future challenges require rising up. I have no doubt at all in this. Mackenzie is someone who doesn't need motivational speeches. Self-motivation is inherent in a wise leader, and it certainly is in Macca. Jess Cleal, meaning gift and also rich, and by experiences, that is. Jess has had many experiences and given to other communities in ways myself twice her age have not gone close to. Her generosity is immense. Jess's nature and internal desire to support others, especially those less advantaged, are things that will hold her steady in future life to come. Jake Kramer. Strength and perseverance are inherent in the meaning of the name Jake. His name is very apt, and I admire everything about Jake. He's much stronger than most, much stronger than he realises, and certainly much stronger than myself. Tom O'Dell, meaning innocent. I might have to check that with Mum, Tom. He reminded me on camp of a certain affable Mark Twain character, Tom Sawyer. His attire varies drastically depending on the occasion, reminiscent of 50s James Dean mixed with Bowie and Hendrix. Illustrious, curious, fighting for what he strongly believes in, we're very glad that you returned to us, Tom. Tom has a gift, and the world will benefit from it in years to come. Emily Pavey. With a meaning of rival or industrious and hardworking, comes from the Latin name Emilia. She was our leader, and I won't say fearless, because there's more to Emily than meets the eye. I think whilst Emily is stronger than most, and certainly has an air of confidence. Peeling layers shows she has a gentle heart and she's very appreciative of others. Luke Peden, with a name meaning the bright one. We have two Lukes in our family. I think bright one refers to Luke's other life, fighting fires and protecting our lives. Luke is like this in his demeanour, having a huge loyalty to our family. His empathy is quiet, gentle, yet as true as it comes. Lily Redman. Lily, the flower by meaning, she is the flower of our group. Like a flower needs care and protection, Lily provides that to our family. Don't cry because it's over. Smile because it happened, Lily. Azra Salmon means travel at night. And I think there's a metaphor that Azra would really resonate with in this. Someone who travels at night is calm, relaxed, with plenty of time to analyse life, which she does oh so well. Azra has taught us all that when you leave negativity alone or behind, you find something beautiful. As a group, because of Azra, we have learnt this life lesson. Luke Walker. Luke, by meaning, is the bright one again, and this can be interpreted in so many ways. He has skills in maths and a passion in this area that will take him in life very far. It also means the one born at dawn. And I do recollect camp memories. When I was trying to sleep in, as I had a 5-month-old and a 2-year-old at home, and I was getting some rest during camp. Thank you for those mornings, Luke. Nuri Yun, meaning shining or light. Nuri has been a bright shining light for our family since joining us in Year 10. She's someone who quietly endures patiently, and endurance is exactly what she showed us on camp, tackling every obstacle without breaking a sweat. She was incredible, and we've all learnt a lot from Nuri's understated yet unwavering solidarity for our team. Cotty House, Class of 2020, if I can impart two words of wisdom upon you, here is the first. Like Nick said, it's a quote from Eleanor Roosevelt, but this is a different one, a favourite of mine. The world belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. You'll find that quote on the wall of my office, a reminder of how lucky we are as educators to have the students we have at BDC. Chase your dreams and believe. The second and final thing is about who you are to others. People will forget what you said. People will forget what you did. But people will never forget how you made them feel. Thank you for letting me into your family. You remind me of how special the bond between a tutor and their group is at BDC. I have a warmer heart because of this Cotty group. Thank you very much.
Please give Cotty House and their tutor teacher, Ms. Verbruggen and Mrs. Law, who cannot join us today, and Mrs. O'Connor, a round of applause.
We now welcome Mrs. Diane Rushforth and Mr. Richard Smith to present Hollows 2020 to the community. Hollows, please line at the stage. Quinn Allen, valedictorian. Saskia Brown, valedictorian, second place in visual arts, effort award in drama, principal's list award. Emily Cruz, valedictorian. Mitchell Hodges, valedictorian, effort award in drama. Ali Martin, valedictorian, first place in Music 1, effort award in English Standard. Annabelle MacDonald, valedictorian. Congratulations. Catherine Murray, valedictorian, first place in personal development, health and physical education, second place in community and family studies, effort award in business studies, female athletics age champion runner-up, and high performance program for surf life saving. Tess Parker Reynolds, valedictorian, effort award in society and culture, effort award in mathematics standard 2, principal's list award, and high performance program for sports aerobics. Samuel Parks, valedictorian, first place in mathematics standard 2, second place in personal development, health and physical education, third place in ancient history, principal's list award, male athletics age champion runner-up. Lily Powell, valedictorian, effort award in mathematics standard 2 and high performance program for equestrian. Biniam Tesfamariam, valedictorian. Matthew Yenger, valedictorian, tied third place in industrial technology.
Good morning to all and to those watching remotely. Congratulations to Year 12 Hollows, who I must say, looking pretty good today. Throwing a group of 20, 13-year-olds together and meeting every day for 6 years is an interesting experiment in human relations. They had to learn how to get along with each other and to form a bond like siblings. It was all fun and games in Tudor until I had to teach them. I had Year 8 Hollows and we were going to make the classic pencil case. I was looking forward to this. I knew them all so well, we were mates. What could go wrong? Never before at Bishop Drewitt College had I needed a seating plan to maintain order. But sure enough, after 2 lessons of chaos, that is where we ended up. I'm constantly surprised by the amazing qualities of this group. They are supremely social, athletic, ethical, and caring. They're addicted to their phones, and they listen to a lot of music. I'm sure they will all be deaf by age 30. They're going to miss those canteen cookies and cheese melts. We said goodbye to 11 of our group along the way, and we wish them well today with fond memories. Georgia, Noor, Ashan, Lachlan, Ari, Esme, Joshua, Jonah, Kaya, Finn, and Wahab. To mix it up a bit, I will present each student like a game of guess who. So, in no particular order, and just to keep you listening, can you guess who? This foundation student is a people person, a hugger who is sentimental and romantic. They have a great voice projection and are an extremely talented student of drama. Chosen for onstage, he might be our next star of Home and Away. Performing arts is where his future lies and what he'll be studying next year. Congratulations, Mitchell Hodges. This person is caring, kind, selfless, and generous. They're always busy supporting important causes. They have a love of the arts, drama, and music in particular. They have regularly sung on Assembly and in Greece the musical. Headed to Melbourne next year to study music performance at Collarts. Congratulations, Ali Martin. This foundation student can be found playing handball at lunchtime, and they're likely to have been fishing or checking the racing odds on the weekend. A talented student and athlete, they'll be playing rugby for Randwick in Sydney next year while studying teaching. Congratulations, Samuel Parks. This person is generally kind, helpful, and fond of the school hat. They are very quiet, but like to keep up a constant friendly argument with their best tutor friend. A brilliant basketball player and member of the Coffs Harbour Suns, he's heading to Newcastle next year to study construction management. Congratulations, Matthew Younger. Always mature, this person is kind and insightful. They often held frequent, urgent, and private conversations with Mitchell during Tudor. Arts captain for 2020, they are talented, perceptive, tolerant, and capable of an intellectual discussion. Your student is headed to Sydney to an arts degree. Congratulations, Saskia Brown. This person is kind-hearted, sensitive, and caring, involved in all sorts of human rights groups and fundraising for charities. They are an avid world traveller and love to explore new places and cultures. This person has early entry to Western Sydney University to study humanitarian aid and disaster relief. Congratulations, Annabelle McDonald. This person is quiet and reserved in our tutor group. They are known for their impressive hairdos and biking skills. They have a strong sense of justice and are very good at arguing their point. He has a cheeky sense of humour and is liked by all. Off to uni after working for a year. Congratulations, Biniam Tesfamariam. This person is kind, generous, and a hard-working student. Fond of a midweek treatment, we have followed the changing hair, skin, and nail colours with interest. A foundation student, they were an elite sports aerobics athlete. She has early entry to uni to study midwifery. Congratulations, Tess Parker Reynolds. This person is likely to be playing handball at lunchtime and has a laid-back style. They love both fishing and surfing and know that the perfect attire for such activities is a pair of Crocs. A foundation student, this social person has led Hollows admirably this year, hoping to be an apprentice electrician. Congratulations, Quinn Allen. This person is athletic and adventurous, a lifesaver on the weekend. They have achieved amazing success in cross-country running and state and national surf life-saving competitions. Courageous, genuine, sports captain for 2020, and a natural leader, this person is looking to work, travel, and then go to uni. Congratulations, Kate Murray. Growing up, this independent sort spent very little time watching Disney movies and much more time with their horses. An elite athlete, this person has competed for Australia in their sport of dressage. Soft-hearted and with a cheeky sense of humour, she's planning to work as a stable hand in the Hunter Valley next year. Congratulations, Lily Rose Powell. This lively, bubbly personality is unafraid to speak their mind, defend their point, and be supportive to a friend in need. A natural leader, they are adventurous, loud, and athletic, and hold many talents in dancing and choreography. She is fearless and heading to a career in the police force. Congratulations, Emily Cruz. I have marked upon my classroom wall all of your heights since year seven, and this will cheer me up when I'm missing you in the years ahead. I would like to thank every one of you for allowing me to share in your lives at such an important stage. I wish you every success. Most of all, I hope you're able to enjoy each and every day and lead a life full of happiness, kindness, and love. Congratulations, Year 12 Hollows.
Dion, can you stay for a photo, please? Dion, yeah, thanks.
Thank you, Dion Rushforth and Mr. Richard Smith. Please congratulate Hollows House and their tutor teacher.
Ms. Kelly Reinhold and Mrs. Sarah Stokes will present Omwari 2020 to the college. Omwari, please line at the stage. Lucy Alkermaid, valedictorian. First place in biology, third place in chemistry, principal's list, female swimming age champion, winner of the Excellence in Science Award. Charlotte Bell, valedictorian, tied second place in hospitality. Samuel Kaywood, valedictorian. Stephen Chang, valedictorian. First place in Music 2, first place in Physics, first place in English Advanced, second place in English Extension 1. Sarah Fay, valedictorian. Second place in Textiles and Design, Effort Award in Economics, Personal Development, Health and Physical Education. Jordan Hill, valedictorian. Third place in Engineering Studies, Effort Award in English Extension 2. Brady McGarry, valedictorian, third place in Mathematics Standard 1. Charlie O'Grady, valedictorian, first place in English Standard. Denver Peterson, valedictorian. Blake Schofield, valedictorian, third place in economics. Samuel Wilson, valedictorian, first place in chemistry, effort award in mathematics extension 1, physics, English advanced, principal's list award.
Well, I have survived and so have my tutor group. I have had this motley group after taking over from Ms. Goodman in Year 10, and what a memorable time it has been. We have managed some guest appearances from Mr. Barron and Ms. Spagliolo as well. There are many memories, some funny, some frustrating, some quite frankly very disturbing. I will miss many things about them as a group, but it will be the individuals, their smiles, their frowns, their anxiety, their stress, their casualness, their intellect, their observations, their caring, their taunting, their compassion, and most of all, their friendship. Dear oh me. All right. Every day when I see them for roll call or tutor group, it's a bit like games night at home, you know, on a Friday. Everyone's there. Everyone comes together as a family. It's something you have to do. Sometimes you don't want to be there, and sometimes it's the only place you want to be. Sometimes you're there under begrudgement because it's still before 11 a.m. in the morning. My group is a bit like games night. Every one of them a different game. There's the game of battleships, always thinking, something deep and on another level. A reason for everything, and then just because. Dropping a bomb of thought or knowledge. Well, that's Stephen. A strategist, and loves a challenge, and loves to challenge. And that's what we love about you. Then there's charades. Well, that would be Jordan. Super quiet. You're always wondering what she's thinking, and a lot of thought goes into what she says and does. You have to guess most of the time, but the signals are there. And when she says something, it is certainly worth listening to. We value her, and we want her on our team, and for everything she has to offer. Chess, a game of skill and precise moves. Things are black or white, and there's a specific reason for everything. That is Sam Wilson. King to queen, king to pawn, checkmate, something like that. Sam is about finding out and engineering opportunities to make the most of a situation. An amazing mind and an amazing individual. Well, this game has been around, and so has this person, Trivial Pursuit. It's a game in which winning is determined by a player's ability to answer general knowledge and random questions. Sometimes you go forward, then you go back, then you go forward, then you come back. Okay, and that would be Denver. Okay, our traveller, and we're happy to see him back to finish with his pursuits with us. Brady, he would be our Jenga. A bit of a task to get him to work the right way and sit in the right order to make it play properly. A game of balance and patience. And in this game, you actually need to work together. But at the same time, you need to be different if you want to stand out and be a winner. But still knowing all along, like Brady, he has the potential to reach great heights. The game of Uno. You have everything in front of you, a bit like Bear Grylls, and then it's up to you to know how to use it. You can throw out, skip a turn, pick up two, stitch up people, and you can even get the wild card, or be as creative as you need to be with your resources and use strategy to help your friends out. This is Charlie. Wild cards, pick up two, the ability to be able to change a game with one planned move, and an amazing source of knowledge. Scrabble. Well, that's just a heap of messy words, no sense, some mutterings and ramblings, and then something wonderful and thoughtful turns out to be a triple word score, like oxyphellobutazone. This is a bit like Lucy. Not quite sure what this means, a bit like Lucy sometimes. She keeps you guessing. But it must be a good top word score, just like Lucy. You're our top word score. Twister. Ooh, this is Sarah, always on the go, a bit like a whirlwind. Legs and lanky arms everywhere, and it'd be no surprise if you were to be accidentally punched in the face. But you know this would be swiftly and accidentally followed by smothering and apologies. She's a wonderful support friend to those around her. Trouble, like the game, as you never know what might pop up. This can only be Sam Kaywood. Like when playing the game, he gets a bit confused in the direction he's heading. He gets knocked around a bit, but he loves it. And everyone is always happy when he makes it home. There was only one person who'd be this next game. A heap of mixed up, made up words, things you quite can't understand, and some things you don't want to understand. Possibly could be the accent. This is Scattergrease, a game with sources of randomness, and also a game that you keep coming back to because you are drawn to it and love it. This is Charlotte. This game is about life, the game of life to be exact. In this game, you take on a role of different people with different responsibilities. You have to make decisions, be an organiser, always making sure that someone thinks of things, even that you're not thinking about yourself, a kind heart, a huge heart, actually, and a guardian of them all. This is Blake, always looking out for everyone else and making sure they are okay. You are an amazing group of young men and women, and it has been a pleasure to spend the last couple of years with you and share everything about you. But our games night has come to an end. Many games require some level of skill and luck, but you will be fine. It's up to you now. Take a chance, roll the dice. You may pass go, but don't collect $200 because I'm broke. And make sure this is the real game of life for you. Play hard, play fair, bend the rules if you have to, you're from Inwari, and enjoy every opportunity that you make for yourselves. Good luck, and I do love you.
Thank you, Mrs. Reinhold and Mrs. Stokes. Round of applause for Inwari House and their tutor teacher.
We now have Murray 2020. Mr. Brett Bennett and Reverend Naomi Cook are presenting Murray to the college. Murray House, please line up at the stage. Charlie Alderman, valedictorian, second place in industrial technology. Edward Berger, valedictorian, second place in French continuous, third place in science extension one. Isaac Butler, valedictorian. Cohen Dean, valedictorian. Meg Denman, valedictorian, first place in drama, second place in society and culture, Principal's List Award. Angus Fitzgerald, valedictorian. Alexis Gunther, valedictorian, second place in chemistry, effort award in mathematics extension two, effort award in mathematics extension one, and unfortunately cannot join us today. Brianna Malouf, valedictorian, effort award in community and family studies, effort award in visual arts. Fergus McNeil, valedictorian, first place in Mathematics Standard 1, second place in Construction. Rachel Newman, valedictorian. Colby Noble, valedictorian, third place in construction. Caleb Ryan, valedictorian, recognition on completing Cert 3 in commercial cooking through TAFE New South Wales. Megan Usher, valedictorian, first place in French continuers, first place in Italian beginners, second place in Science Extension 1, effort award in Mathematics Advanced and Principal's List Award. Isabel Watson, valedictorian, first place in Community and Family Studies, first place in Ancient History, third place in Mathematics Advanced, third place in Biology, tied third place in English Advanced, Effort Award in Mathematics Advanced, and Principal's List Award.
Welcome, good morning, no, good afternoon, everyone. Okay, here we go. So to begin, I'm going to say people here who know me probably know there are some things about BDC I would like to change. And I will keep pushing for a board shorts and thongs summer uniform, for a three-day school week, teepees for classrooms, and for an attendance optional policy on sunny days with good surf. Mr. Johnson, are you listening? but what I would say is there's one thing I wouldn't change. There's lots, actually. There's lots. But this one especially. And that is how we do the tutor thing at BDC. It is such a wonderful experience as a teacher to be able to build a really special relationship with students over an extended period of time. I talked a little in our house farewell yesterday about this, but for us here at BDC, the tutor relationship is not just another class. We are together in one way or another every single day, and that builds a special connection, a relationship that really only can be compared to that of a family. We get to know each other through the exciting moments and the mundane everyday moments, through stressful times and through some pretty chill times. We had lots of those. Through happy and sometimes some sad times too. And through it all, we stick and we've stuck together like a family. When we come together in our little tutor family, we come together with love and support, with kindness and understanding. We're not worrying then about getting marked or assessed or ranked or judged. We come together to be together and experience our school and life together. We come together to nurture each other and support each other to be ourselves as we really are. And when I say we, I really mean all of us together. Not me, the teacher, teaching, but all of us learning together along the way. And I really feel like we have learned so much together. We've just been through a very special experience at retreat the last few days. And to see you all there, it's so honest and brave and compassionate and kind and understanding and forgiving, that really cemented for me the quality of the young people here that we are about to send out into the world. You guys were all so impressive, and I'm so proud. On the retreat, I was also really humbled and to be honoured by you guys in our circle. And yesterday, I was presented with this amazing little booklet. And sitting down to read that at home last night, I got to say, I got a little misty. Maybe a lot misty. it's just so beautiful. Such heartfelt words, and thank you all so very, very much. I'd like to take a brief moment to honour you guys in return, and it is brief. I could say so much more, but I know this guy over here will be, yanking me off the stage. So just a little bit about these guys. So Charlie's so kind, and he has such a warm heart. He's calm and gentle, and he is genuinely humble. No false modesty there. A natural leader, and a leader for all the right reasons. Ed, there he is. Ed's a quiet achiever. He dipped in and out a little bit over the last couple of years, But he was always there with us. He's the quiet achiever and a big thinker. He already knows a lot about the world and he understands the forces of injustice out there. He cares. And the world certainly needs more people who care. Isaac, underneath, there's a bit of a tough exterior there with Isaac, but he is such a sensitive little soul, a truly beautiful soul. He really feels and he rewards friendship with real loyalty and love. Koi, he is almost the perfect embodiment of the stereotype of the gentle giant. That's what a kind and caring heart beats inside that big frame. He's just so solid in the very truest sense. Meg, well, we thought we'd lost Meg for a while way back in year 8. Thankfully, she came back to us because in many ways, Meg is the beating heart of our little group, or the mama of our group, as Koi called her on retreat. Meg's a true altruist who always considers others before herself, a beautiful and kind soul. Angus, even though he doesn't let on too much a lot of the time, Angus is deep. He takes it all in around him and he moves through the world in such an easygoing way. Respect. He's a really gentle soul and he's got so much to offer the world and a smile to melt even the hardest of hearts. Lexi, unfortunately, it's very sadly, Lexi's not able to be with us here today. What I'd say about Lexi is he's a thinker and he's a thinker who cares about other people. He has the deepest respect for all humanity and he embraces and learns from the wisdom of other cultures. Our love goes out to you today, Lexi. Hope you're better soon, mate. Bree's just such a sweet-natured young person. She's the perfect house leader. I've been watching Bree really grow into herself, especially over the last year or so. She's become more confident and self-assured. And yeah, I just know that she's destined for really something really special. Fergus, there's so much love out there for Fergus. And it's easy to see why, because he gives so much. He never judges unfairly. And he takes everyone just as they are, which is such a beautiful quality. And he's risen above challenges with such dignity. Nice one. Rachel, what a shining little light Rachel is. Her heart beats so pure and true. I think sometimes she doesn't know just how much she brings to people around her. Just know it, Rachel. We love you. Colby is always great fun and great fun to be around. But he's so much more as well. Watching him really grow into himself and become the amazing young guy before us now has been such a pleasure. His kindness and compassion on retreat was a real signal of the good man that he's become. Caleb. Takes a little while to get to know Caleb. Well, once you do, you'll get to know such a genuinely loyal and considerate young guy. I'll always remember Caleb on year 11 camp. He's just stepping up every single time. You can really count on him. And that's a really wonderful quality. Megan. I'd say about Megan is that only the genuinely cool people are cool without trying. That's Megan. She is effortlessly cool. She's just there for everyone around her, quietly, gently, supportive, and considerate. Perfect friend a beautiful person. Belle. Belle. Always the last on the list with the W surname. Never ever last in our hearts. There's so much love and admiration for Belle because, well, she's just Belle. She's so kind, so caring, so gentle and compassionate, and she just gives and gives and gives. From all of us, I know I can say thank you, Belle. So there it is. Our official time together has come to an end. To parents out there, thank you for allowing me to share some growing up time with your amazing children. I really thank you. It really is a privilege. To Year 12 Murray, thank you for sharing this little part of your life journey, for sharing the joy and the tears, the good times and the occasional stumbles along the way. I hope you know you go out into the world now with my deepest blessings. You all have so much to give and so many new adventures and experiences ahead of you. Embrace your life and live it. Much love to you all. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Brett Bennett and Reverend Naomi Cook. And please put your hands together for Murray House and their tutor teacher.
We now ask Mrs. Claire Murphy and Mr. Shane Oxley to present O'Shane Tutor Group for 2020. O'Shane House, please line up at the stage. Christian Albina, valedictorian. Third place in Mathematics Extension 2, Principal's List Award. Jonah Bedford, valedictorian. Second place in Engineering Studies. Tied second place in Drama. Tied third place in English Advanced. Effort Award in Biology. Gwyn Bynan, valedictorian. Second place in English Standard. Ebony Casagrande, valedictorian. First place in Accelerated HSC Studies of Religion 2 in 2019. First place in Visual Arts, first place in English Extension 2, first place in English Extension 1, second place in English Advanced, Principal's List Award. Samuel Goodwin, valedictorian, second place in Physics, third place in Music 2, Effort Award in Chemistry, Principal's List Award. Alexandra Hill, valedictorian. Effort Award in Personal Development, Health and Physical Education. Bailey Capicoya, valedictorian. First place in Science Extension 1. Effort Award in Biology. Effort Award for Mathematics Advanced. Effort Award in English Advanced. Principal's List Award. Sahibveer Kunkun Singh, valedictorian. Second place in History Extension 1. Imogen Leary, valedictorian. Second place in Italian beginners. Third place in French continuous. Kodai McCuni, valedictorian. Effort award in biology. Yusuf Musri, valedictorian. Second place in Mathematics Standard 1. Effort award in Mathematics Standard 1. Thomas Sweeney, valedictorian. Male athletics age champion, male swimming age champion runner-up. Jesse Woodward, valedictorian. First place in Japanese continuous, second in music 2, third place in mathematics extension 1, principal's list award.
Okay, first up, I'd just like to thank Mick and the Dream Team of tutors, the pastoral care team and our heads of O'Shane House. We've certainly felt the love and support and are really grateful. Thank you to the other tutors who have been a part of our O'Shane family along the way, Mrs. Charmaine Harrington, Miss Pam Moran and Mrs. Julie Bain. We love you. Parents and carers, we know you're hurting not being able to be here today. This group has talked about this a lot. A common theme from the last few days of reflection was that BDC was the place everyone in our group needed to be. And that even though they may not have always made this evident to you, they appreciate the choices and the sacrifices you've made. So thank you for your support, your patience, your communication, and fingers crossed we'll get to have that dance with you in November. Year 12, O'Shane. You're certainly a group like no other. Back in 2015, when the world was divided by the important question of is the dress white and gold or is it black and blue, I was simply not prepared for the way you walked through that door and pulled at my heartstrings. You were keen little people with overloaded school bags and way too many questions. I clearly remember on that first day telling you about how awesome high school would be and how you should be knocking down doors to make the most of everything on offer. However, I soon lived to regret this advice, as it turns out you volunteered for everything. O'Shane House video for House Shout, we'll do it. In-house speaking comp, yep, no worries. Over the years though, we smashed nearly every O'Shane tutor challenge, maybe with a little bit of cheating. And when there was an O'Shane music comp, most groups had their solo piano player or singer, but no, not you lot. We had to transport half the equipment from the music block down to the Branson Centre, and we had a full band, including backup singers and dancers. It was all in. Even in year 8 and 9, when you all grew overnight, everyone seemed to get braces, and you were either hungry, grumpy, or pretty much vacant teenagers, it still didn't take much to get you involved. You radiate energy. You've always radiated energy. And whether it's finding the loopholes in Foundation Day activities, setting up a campaign for a missing pet, Gerald, who, funnily enough, we've never found, experimenting with house chants that the world wasn't quite ready for, playing Uno, following up on Wiley's promise to cut his hair if Trump was elected, fire building on camp, or leading the way with participation at every school carnival or celebration, you've always been all in and has made all the difference. We've always had quite an eclectic bunch of kids in our group, some the best of mates, others not natural friends, but you're all still close. In his closing comments to us, James, our beloved Year 11 camp instructor, said he'd usually tell kids to make an effort to be supportive throughout Year 12, but he didn't think he needed to say that to you lot as you arrived at camp this way. In fact, I think he thought we were a little too close at times. Two things come to mind about your senior years when I think about your strength of character. The first being the chance the majority of you took to put yourselves out there for leadership positions. It takes guts. Standing behind you when the leaders were announced nearly ripped my heart out as I watched the joy, but also the disappointment you experienced. I was so proud of the mature and respectful way all of you handled it, official leaders or not. A lot of the time in life, it's what you do with your disappointments that counts. And as a group, you decided you'd all be leaders of some sort, and that's exactly what you've done. Every time we've turned around, there was O'Shane leading the way, whether it be Shave for a Cure, artwork for the fashion or the fashion parade for Cambodia, Grease the musical, pushing for extension subjects to run, or driving the idea of the Year 12 yearbook. You were there leading the way. The second thing being, this year has been hard. Year 12 is always hard, but this year has been exceptional. You've vented, adapted, vented, adjusted, and vented again and again, and have come through it. You've dealt with changes and disappointments, the limited ways to celebrate your 17ths and 18ths, which just quietly I was quite happy to know you're locked up at home, and so many unknowns. Yet still, you got through your HSC trials. You're here, you're healthy, you're graduating, you do look fabulous, by the way, and you're ready to take on whatever comes next. You got this. One incredible act of kindness that stands out, that pretty much sums up what wonderful humans you are, is our Kris Kringle of 2019. You pooled your money, and with much giggling, excitement, and assembling skills, you managed to put together a bike as a surprise for Yusuf. Who does this? Teenagers get such a bad rap for being so self-absorbed, and yet here you were, generously creating a moment that I doubt he'll ever forget. None of us will ever forget. It's just typical of our group. Okay, so now it's up to you. We're going to miss you. There's no rush, but I'll be expecting to hug those tutor grandchildren one day. Stick to the winning formula of simply being yourselves, because no matter what you experience, know that you are enough. You've always been enough, just the way you are. Thanks.
Thank you, Mrs. Claire Murphy and Mr. Shane Oxley. Please congratulate Year 12 O'Shane and their tutor teacher.
We welcome Mr. Craig Lang and Mr. Simon Doyle to present Sutherland 2020 to the college. Sutherland House, please line up the stage. Joshua Corey, valedictorian. William Crowe, valedictorian, effort award in mathematics, standard 2. Bianca Dijon, valedictorian, effort award in society and culture, principal's list award, recognition on completing Cert 3 in human services through TAFE, New South Wales. Lucy Garner, valedictorian, first place in society and culture, first place in business studies, second place in accelerated HSC studies of religion 2 in 2019, second place in English extension 2, third place in English extension 1 and principal's list award. Georgia Hansard, valedictorian, second place in legal studies, third place in mathematics standard 2, third place in visual arts, third place in English extension 2, effort award in English extension 1, effort award in English advanced, effort award in English extension 2, effort award in mathematics standard 2 and principal's list award. Blake Island, valedictorian, third place in legal studies, effort award in ancient history. Achol Jock, valedictorian, first place in History Extension 1, second place in Ancient History, third place in Accelerated HSC Studies of Religion 2 in 2019, Effort Award in Biology, and Effort Award in English Advanced. Lucia Jones, valedictorian, third place in Community and Family Studies. Freya Lamont, valedictorian, first place in Textiles and Design, Principals List Award. Kyle Lang, valedictorian, first place in economics, tied second place in drama. Caitlin Lastovec, valedictorian, first place in legal studies, second place in economics, third place in Society and Culture, Effort Award for Mathematics Advanced, Effort Award in English Advanced, and Principals List Award. Angus Longworth Brown, valedictorian, first place in Software Design and Development, first place in Mathematics Extension 2, second place in Accelerated HSC Mathematics Advanced in 2019, third place in Physics, Principals List Award. Emily Meacham, valedictorian, first place in Accelerated HSC Mathematics Advanced in 2019, second place in Mathematics Extension 2, second place in Biology, third place in Accelerated HSC Mathematics Extension 1 in 2019, female swimming age champion runner-up. Noah Oxley, valedictorian, second place in Music 1. Shannon Stafford, valedictorian, third place in Personal Development, Health and Physical Education. Paris Warnican, valedictorian, Effort Award in Business Studies. Kenya Whelan, valedictorian.
So here we are, still together. I've been with this group since day one of high school. Of course, I've known a number of them, and more of you, since day one of kindy. Who can forget the famous hot glue gun incident? I've never been allowed to. And of course, I've known one of you since before day one. Needless to say, it has been quite a joy to watch Year 12 Sutherland, and the rest of you for that matter, grow to become the adults I am extremely proud of. And of course, thanks to all the parents, I can truly relate to how you feel and know you are very proud of them. Wish me luck in trying to get through this speech. For those of you who have seen me do an end of tutor speech before, and there are many of you out there, I tend to present my speech through a prism. It helps me get through it. Of course, it's much harder this year, as I've sat through five of these since taking over the group and teared up each time. I considered bands, movie casts, TV shows, but decided only one really fit perfectly for these guys. So here I stand, strangely dreaming of being one of Australia's most high-profile coaches. Justin, or Mr. Langer to you, Australia's cricket coach. Great name almost, an even better coach, to talk about the outstanding team I've had the pleasure of working with for 6 years. I have to start on a cricket theme with the opening pair, Pez Elise Perry and Midge Alyssa Healy, or as we know them, Pusia. I would usually be adamant not to talk about two students together, but that wouldn't do the nature of Lucia's and Pusia's relationship justice. It's all about the twin speak, finishing each other's sentences, abusing each other, or laughing without actually saying anything. The rest of us were often bemused. However, they always cracked us up and kept us entertained. Josh, Skunky, Pat Rafter. Known for his friendly nature, he was the cool, calm customer who was always able to bring the team together with a quiet, encouraging words and lovely blonde locks, but he certainly fired up when we needed to compete. Will, Dizzy, Jason Gillespie, known for his crazy hair as much as his talent. He's a young, humble young man who prefers to let his actions speak louder than his words. When something needed to be done, he was always ready to stand up, no questions asked. Bianca, Belle, Belinda Clark, known as the kindest, loveliest and most selfless players of all time, who always puts the team first no matter how she feels, was also known for having a smile that lights up a room. Lucy, Ash Barty. Like Ash, Lucy proves that great things really do come in small packages. She combines talent with courage and determination to achieve at the highest level. She was always ready to take on that challenge. Georgia, our Kathy Freeman, known for her passion for human rights and always ready to stand up for what she believes in. Her voice is clear and strong, and her determination is fierce. Blake, Bam Bam, David Pocock. His strength comes from his deeds and positive attitude, always ready to stand up for others, and many times throughout the 13 years, I was still in awe of his resilience. And readiness to put others first. A child, happy, Steph Gilmore. Like Steph, she finds the ocean her quiet place. Always ready with a smile, she thinks deeply about the world. And I'm sure her intelligent perspective will change many. Freya, Jacko, Lauren Jackson. Once upon a time, she was the tallest member of our group. Freya was always ready to encourage the team in her insightful manner, with her intelligence and genuine smile. Caitlin, Mirzi, Anna Mears, determined to give everything a go, remains one of the most earnest students I've had the pleasure of teaching. You only had to ask her once and it was done. Angus, Goat, Nathan Lyon. Intelligent, gifted, and more than a bit quirky. It has been wonderful to watch him grow in confidence and show his wide range of abilities and qualities to the group and to the school. Emily, Millionaire Matilda, Sam Kerr, supremely gifted athletically and academically, has it all and is so likeable with it. She can do it all and will always step up, loves to compete in her truly humble way. Noah, Warnie, Shane Warne, just loves sport and will get into anything. Keen to perform with a wide range of deliveries in both music and drama. Unlike Warnie, he does it all with a caring nature. Shannon, Sally Pearson, fiercely determined, but also prefers to avoid the limelight. However, will step up when needed and always keen to support others in her strong, quiet way. Kenya Dawny Dawn Fraser, outspoken and ready to share her feelings with those around her. She is ready to smile, laugh and cry, always wears a heart on her sleeve, but is always genuine in her intentions for others. Last but certainly not least, our captain Kyle. Loud and brash, but always keen to put the performance of the team first. Took house shout to a whole new level for other houses to chase. Punter Ricky Ponting always stepped up to perform when we and I needed him. I won't give too much advice now. You've heard plenty over the years. Most of all, find people who are prepared to work with you and support you come what may. You will achieve great things. No matter how long it has been, feel free to keep in touch. I look forward to hearing how life is treating you. You remain in my heart. Remember always, we are Savant. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Lang and Mr. Doyle. Please congratulate Year 12 Sutherland and their tutor teacher.
We will now hear from Caden Lastovig and Mitchell Hodges, who will reply on behalf of Year 12 and give their valedictorian response.
Hello, everyone. We have finally made it. 13 years of schooling have accumulated to this day. Well, actually, five-ish weeks from now, we will sit our first HSE exam. But we don't want to get caught up in the technicalities. Today is a day of celebration. A celebration that we share with our peers, parents, teachers, and friends. Before we start reminiscing and crying tears of nostalgia, on behalf of the class of 2020, we want to thank a number of individuals for their support through our schooling journey. We want to thank our parents and guardians for pulling us through various mental breakdowns, supporting us through the trials and tribulations of high school life, and loving us through the good, the bad, and the ugly. And trust me, there was a lot of ugly. From our first day of school to our very last, you have watched us grow and become the strong-willed, loud group of young adults that we are. The English language does not have the capacity to express the level of gratitude that we have for you.
A huge thank you to Ben and the Canteen Committee for keeping us fed, and a special shout out to Mitch for being the mate that we never knew we needed. Thank you to the cleaning staff for always cleaning up after us, after big events, and always making sure our classrooms were spick and span. To the office staff, thank you for signing us in most mornings when traffic made us late, and for all of the background organizational projects that you perform. Thank you to the groundsmen for always keeping the ovals in pristine condition for the inter-school soccer matches that we all miss dearly. And a huge thank you for making sure that we go in and out of school safely on a daily basis. Thank you to Mr. Doyle for all of the background effort that you have put into our year to ensure that this year went as smoothly as it possibly could. We know that it was tough, and we thank you from the bottom of our hearts and appreciate the time and effort. And Gina, thank you for absolutely everything that you have done for our year. You are the sole reason many of us received an early entry offer for university or have apprenticeships. I will miss my phone's buzz notifying a new Google Classroom update from you, Gina. If not for your support, we would have not been able to get through this year with any future career prospects. Thank you from the bottom of our heart.
A huge thank you to the people who have helped us through the last 13 years of schooling, the teachers. It has been both a pain but also an honour to have been taught by so many of you. We thank you for the memories that we have been fortunate enough to create with you, from Miss Mullenbrook's dancing on tables in Year 3 to in year five, Miss Davis making her class do commando in the morning. We have all had our ups and downs, like missing out on golden time for writing and passing notes in Mr. Freeman's year six class, and you have seen us grow from the cute little munchkins to the hairy Bigfoots that we've become. Sorry, high school teachers, but you really got the short end of the stick here. You've had to put up with us through hormones, puberty, and discovering our limits. Thank you, high school teachers, for the memorable moments like Miss Bain never remembering her lines in Grease the Musical, and to the countless Frozo runs we've had in Hospo. Thank you, Miss O'Connor. You guys have been everything and anything we could have asked for, and it has been the most amazing 13 years of our lives. We thank you so, so much for being by our side through the thick and thin. You teachers are amazing, and with love and memories, thank you from the class of 2020.
To our tutors, or better described as our surrogate parents, thank you for being with us while we created memories. Thank you for making even the most mundane tasks, like roll call, entertaining. We would like to express our deepest gratitude for being an ear to rant to, a shoulder to cry on, a book of wisdom, and even just a person to share our wild weekend antics. And finally, to the man, the myth, the legend, Clippo. In year seven, we're a bunch of misfit kids who had our doubts about having you as our year coordinator through to year 12. But you completely blew our expectations out the window. We would not be standing here today without you. Mick, you have helped many of us through so much. You have been there for us when it seemed like no one was. And because of this support, in our eyes, you are more than just a year coordinator. You are more than just another teacher to us. You're a friend. You are family.
Mick, even through the uncertainties of 2020, you have put nothing but energy into this year group. Your efforts have not gone unnoticed, and as year coordinator, you have truly gone above and beyond your duties. Thank you for your continued support and your guidance through high school. You are, and always will be, a role model for us. Your ability to take the diverse group of people that is our cohort under your wings and encourage us to reach our potential as human beings is unmatched. Mick, you have been the light for many of us. Always being there for us, you were able to sense when something was up and you would never hesitate to ask if there was anything you could do to help, even with out-of-school problems. Mick, we've sobbed on for long enough. I will never be able to put into words how much your leadership has meant to us. We are forever grateful. Just remember, this is not a goodbye, but this is a warm hello to a long-lasting friendship. As a symbol of this friendship, the class of 2020 would like to present to you a gift to represent our future relationship. We will keep in contact, and I'm sure we'll reach out when the big scary world gets to us. Thank you, Mick.
With all of this said and done, today might be one of the last times that this group of people are sitting in the same room together. To the year of 2020, we've had our ups and downs, but through everything we've been through, I feel as if we're one big happy family, happy dysfunctional family, who is finally old enough to let our wings spread and go off to bigger and better things. Thank you.
Thank you, Caitlin and Mitchell. I would now like to invite Mr. Verbruggen to the lectern to present the special awards to Year 12.
Could I please invite Mr. Doyle, Ms. Cook, Ms. O'Connor, Mr. Clippen and Mr. Johnston to the stage. Mr. Doyle will present the first awards. Commencing with our sports awards for 2020. For Outstanding Male Sports Person of the Year Award, congratulations, Mackenzie Caruana. Mm-hmm.
could all awardees stand on the front after receiving their awards? We'll hold applause till the very end, thank you. For Outstanding Female Sports Person of the Year Award, congratulations, Lucy Alchemade. The 2020 UNE Vice Chancellor's High Achievement Prize. Congratulations to two awardees, Emily Meacham and Kenya Whelan. The 2020 University of Newcastle Vice Chancellor Award for Academic Excellence in Year 12 Prize. Congratulations, Isabel Watson. All Vice Chancellor's Prizes are a $2,000 prize awarded to them studying at the university. The Southern Cross University Chancellor's Scholarship goes congratulations to Bianca de Jong. The Assistant Principal's Award. Congratulations, Bailey Kapakaya. The Coastal Wardrobes and Kitchens Excellence in Work Placement Award. Congratulations to two students, Anthony Abella for Construction and Luke Peden for Hospitality. Thank you, Mr. Doyle. The following special awards are presented to students through a range of areas of excellence criteria. I would like to ask Reverend Naomi Cook to come forward to present the following awards. The PNF Association Perpetual Trophy for Leadership. Congratulations, Angus Longworth Brown. The Terry Muldoon Award for Learning, Resilience and Commitment. Congratulations, Luke Walker. The BDC Gujar Award. Congratulations, Jonah Bedford. Thank you, Reverend Cook. I now call on Mrs. Sue O'Connor to present our next special awards to the recipients. The Branson Award for Persistence, awarded to a student who has shown the greatest persistence through adverse times. Congratulations, Isabel Watson. The Branson Acklin Award for Performing Arts. Congratulations, Ebony Casagrande. The College Service Award. Congratulations, Blake Schaffel. The Caltex Award for the Best All-Rounder. Congratulations, Sam Goodwin.
Thank you, Mrs. O'Connor. I'd now like to call on Mr. Clippen to present the following awards. The ADF Long Tan Leadership and Teamwork Award, Year 12. Congratulations, Charlie Alderman. The ADF Future Innovators Award. Congratulations, Luke Walker. Most Improved. Congratulations to two students, Tess Parker Reynolds and Luke Walker. I would like to invite Mr. Johnston to present the Principal's Awards along with Mr. Doyle. The student who receives our BDC Ducks each year is determined by the highest ATAR received. This is announced mid-December and the student is invited to attend our Foundation Day service to receive their award. The following three awards are our 2020 Principal's Awards, and the College community would now like to acknowledge the students who've received excellent results across their HSC coursework. For recognition of receiving third place in HSC coursework 2020, we congratulate Lucy Garner. For recognition of receiving second place in HSC coursework 2020, we congratulate Stephen Chang. For recognition of receiving first place in HSC coursework 2020, we congratulate Ebony Casagrande. Please, a big congratulations to all of our Class of 2020.
I would like to invite Mrs. Sarah Stokes and Mr. Nick Johnston to the stage to acknowledge our Foundation students who have been with us and completed their school life since starting kindergarten at BDC in 2008. Please come forward when your name is called. Anthony Abella, Charlie Alderman, Jonah Bedford, Samuel Kaywood, Bianca DeJong, Alexandra Hill, Jordan Hill, Mitchell Hodges, Blake Ireland, Lucia Jones, Sahib Kun Kun Singh, Kyle Lang, Angus Longworth Brown, Brianna Maloof, Colby Noble, Tess Parker Reynolds, Samuel Parks, Luke Peden, Caleb Bryan, Luke Walker, Paris Warnican, and Isabel Watson. Congratulations to our foundation students. I'd now like to invite Claire Beery and Jane Dancy Spain and Michael Clippen to the stage, please. Jane and Claire have been working tirelessly to make the Branson Centre look and feel as amazing as you see it today. COVID times have spoiled or forced a change to many of your events this year, and it has been their mission to make this event as special as possible. Rightly so, this is the most spectacular the Branson Centre has ever looked. Please accept this gift with many thanks. Jane Dancy Spain. We just said thank you to you for making this look so beautiful. Mick Clippen. Mick has been a year coordinator for 19 years at Bishop Drewitt College and has decided not to continue with a new group of students next year. During his time as a year coordinator, he has helped shape and create over 2,000 students' lives. 2,000. That's a pretty impressive legacy to leave behind. Thank you, Mick. You are one of the most caring and genuine human beings I know. You advocate incessantly for the students in your care. They are always your number one priority and you are a fierce protector of them. These students here leave as well-rounded and grounded young adults as a result of the last 6 years with you as their year coordinator. Please accept this gift as a small token of our appreciation from Bishop Drewitt for your tireless work as a year coordinator.
Thank you, Mrs. O'Connor. I will now call on the Year 12 service captains to speak about Year 12 fundraising and present a framed stole to Nick Johnston and a special gift on behalf of Year 12.
Over the course of the year, the Class 2020 has been involved in a number of fundraisers for causes and foundations based locally, statewide and globally. As a year group, we have raised money together for Shave for a Cure, about $15,000 to support four different community service organisations that we visited in Cambodia and through the Christmas Helper Appeal. We have contributed along with the school to Warriners Women's and Children's Refuge in Coffs Harbour. Overall, it has been a combined effort from both students and staff from the college to make any possible fundraiser happen. So before we move on, we'd like to sincerely thank all the college staff for contributing their time to make any of these events happen in the first place, as well as the students from across the years for their efforts in participating in fundraising events. In March, right before we went into quarantine, the wonderful students in Year 12 shaved their heads to show solidarity for those living with cancer and raised awareness for the campaign and additionally raised over $13,000 for funds for the foundation.
In addition to the money that has already been donated, we have raised a further $4,000. Alongside with the entirety of the college gathers and presents to the Warina Women's Refuge during the Christmas season, Year 12 have also contributed $1,000 to the specialist service for assistance in extending their services to women and children who have experienced domestic and family violence. We've also managed to raise and donate $1,000 to Friends of the Koalas, a campaign that fights for the Northern Rivers Koalas. They promote awareness and encourage discussion by bringing issues to the public's attention through the media and then provide information and advice. Another $1,000 has been donated to Bridging the Gap. The foundation funds research in health and education in order to address one of Australia's most urgent issues, the gap between Indigenous and non-Indigenous Australians' health and education opportunities and outcomes. Due to the emergence of COVID, a number of planned events to further assist our community locally and statewide has had restrictions stamped on it. However, if there's one thing we realise the importance of because of the pandemic, it's that of keeping in touch and helping out in any way we can to those who are not provided with the freedom, funds and resources during this challenging time. In light of this, we have donated $1,000 to our sister school in Cambodia, Kriyong School. We'd now like to present a gift to Mr. Johnston on behalf of the class of 2020. Mr. Johnston? Oh, he's there. Okay.
Thank you, Ezra, and Charlotte, and thank you, class of 2020, for that, the very generous heart you have, and Mick talked about that before, and all your tutor staff. So now it's getting that important time for kindergarten. However, I'll just do a few quick acknowledgements, because after that we will do our own exit for our rose ceremony. And after that, we're actually going to ask you to return for your group photo while we get your lunch ready. So our photo will be actually in the Branson Centre. Okay. We would like to thank Reverend Cook, Mick Lippin and Jane Mosco for the last 2 days on Monday and Tuesday that we had. They were quite incredible at the Red Sea Centre on the harbour. We would also like to thank Reverend David and Reverend Cook for their ongoing faith leadership and support. Our staff assistants, the performance people we saw on the screen today, our many Year 11 captains that have been doing things on the stage, but also out there in the Branson Centre. Certainly our audiovisual team, Holly, we couldn't have done today without you and your expertise. So thank you, Holly, Patrick and John Logan Entertainment. Thank you, JLE. Our kindergarten staff, Ms. Muhlenbrooks, Hazel Buchanan, Mr. Mack. The setups and the anguish Mr. Mack has had is been... He's handled it really well, so thank you for that. Obviously, Miss Beery and Miss Jane Dancy-Spain for setting up. Obviously, there's lots of teams that have made today happen, so thank you, because you're all made the day, I think, extra special. And of course, our parents, carers and families for being online today. Most of all, thank you to the wellbeing team, Mrs. O'Connor, Year Coordinator Mr. Clippin, our counsellors, Jane Mosco, Saskia Klopp, Pam Moran in the LRC, and of course all our Year 12 tutor leaders for your everyday support of Year 12 in particular, and all our students. So this really concludes the formal part of our valedictory assembly. So we now congratulate you, and we now will commence with the traditional rose ceremony as our kinders are led in by Michael and I think Ellie. Welcome, guys. Just follow Michael. Just a reminder while they come in that at home, some of the music may not be broadcast. It won't be your speaker though, we're just respecting the rights of that song owner. They look pretty amazing as they come on in. Welcome. You look amazing, guys, welcome, come on in.
We would like to thank the support of kindergarten teachers Mrs. Emily Cadwell, Mrs. Gillian Fisher, Mrs. Sharon Habgood, and Mr. Ty Gillen, along with our directors, Mrs. Truce Muhlenbrooks, Mrs. Ruth Stewart, and kindergarten students for their signed and recorded recital of What a Wonderful World. Please enjoy.
I think they're going to be the class of 2031, I think, if my mathematics is right. Crikey. Congratulations, kindergarten. Thank you, kindergarten, Mrs. Stewart, Mrs. Muhlenbrooks, and of course our kindergarten teachers. Just give them another round of applause, please. Just incredible. I can tell you that Miss Stewart, Miss Muhlenbrooks were over the moon that they came up with the idea that they could sign the song. So thank you guys for that. Thank you for being so creative. While that's happening, I invite all staff present here today to move to the entrance to meet our valedictorians, our newest B2C alumni. So all staff present, I ask you to head over to the entrance. And I also ask Mr. Clippett and Mr. Johnson and Miss O'Connor to please hand out the roses ready for our graduands, our valedictorians. Thank you again, Ruth. Thank you, Kindy. Now, BDC valedictorians, there is actually a personalised card attached to each flower. And that was obviously created by kindergarten, and that's Mrs. Rachel Canali, who works up in our reception area. That was her creativity. So it's truly a team effort here today. What I encourage you to do is, Mrs. O'Connor will ask us to move probably a table at a time. You head out, you definitely need some fresh air. The formalities are over, but we're going to ask you after that. Mr. Clippin will direct you back in. Our photo will be here, and while that's happening, we'll get water out, we'll get the food out. So congratulations, and thanks to Jaylee again. And Mrs. O'Connor, we're in your hands.
You're not done yet, Mitch. All right. Year 12, as you sit and you start eating, not unfortunately, we are running very late, which isn't unfortunate because it's been beautiful so far. What it does mean, though, is to get the full guard of honour in, we actually need to be hurrying up with what we have got, because you may not have noticed, but it is 2 o'clock. We were going to be finished about half an hour ago completely. So while you are eating, I'm going to ask Meg and Sass to come and give part two of the Year 12 speech. So have a quick drink, Meg. Have a quick drink. When they are finished, while they're just coming up and gathering themselves, this is about 30 seconds notice, while they're just getting themselves ready, after they have finished speaking, we are going to be watching a movie that has been put together by The Young Years by Bree, The Middle School Years by Yusuf, and The Senior School Years by Georgia. So, in anticipation, while you've got half a mouthful of food, a huge welcome to Sass and Meg, and thank you to the movie makers.
Okay. first of all, we want to reiterate how the love and support from all of our parents and teachers has helped us overcome the amount of obstacles that we have been faced with this year. Although so many important people who have framed our entire high school lives in the most positive, supportive, and inspiring ways possible can't be here today, we see you, we love you, and appreciate everything that you've done to propel us to be the best people we can be. Your impact on our lives as we grow into the adults we aspire to be is everlasting. We want to highlight how our cohort has been the biggest support system we have. We speak on behalf of our entire year when saying that this year would have been immensely harder without you all.
We made it. And I don't mean we made it as if we made it to the end of high school. I mean we made it through 13 years of schooling. We made it through our first day of kindy to our first day of high school. And starting at the beginning of high school, we made it through dealing with teachers that we don't like, subjects that we hated. We made it through PE, PDH, science, drama, art, maths, history, music, tech, English, religion, tutors, chapel, house meetings, NAPLAN, and many challenging and exciting camps. We had to wake up and get to school and start a six-period day full of classes. We either get bombarded with new information or get stuck with daydreams and dozing off. We made it through electives, then we made it through year 11, we made it through the new leadership system, we were the first to make it through the minimum standards, and then we made it and continue to make it through a global pandemic.
As well as surviving year 12, we did it while overcoming online school, constantly checking in on one another, making sure we were all hanging in there. Our expectations were constantly changing, yet we continued to push through. If we aren't the toughest year 12 to come out of high school, I don't know who is. We overcame all of this because of each other.
Each and every single one of you has had an impact on every single other person sitting in this room, and we couldn't have picked a better bunch of people to go through this journey with. Now we know that some of us know exactly what we want to do when they finish school, and some don't, and that's okay. But we can safely say that every single one of us is going to succeed, because after this roller coaster of a year, there's nothing the world can throw at us that we can't handle.
We see the light that each person in this room carries, and we speak with all confidence when saying that we are going to make this world a better place as we venture down our own roads of life. This is just our foundation.
We worked so incredibly hard for this moment, and we deserve it. This exact moment, the moment we are recognised as the graduating class of 2020.
So, a toast, if we can all hold up our water. I don't have any, but, To our support systems, our family, our teachers, to everyone in this room, and to those who are watching from our screen, and to most importantly, us, the class of 2020, we did it.
Remember the days at the old schoolyard? We used to laugh a lot. Oh, don't you remember the days at the old schoolyard? When we had imaginings and we had all kinds of things and we laughed and needed love, yes I do. Oh, and I remember you. Remember the days of the old schoolyard? Simplicity, and we had warm toast for tea, and we laughed and needed love. Yes, I do. Oh, and I remember you.
Like all of the tutors up here, please. So while they're coming up, we've heard quite a bit about... Come on up, don't be shy. We've heard quite a lot about the tutors and they've certainly had their opportunity speaking to you. It's my opportunity to say something about them. I don't know about this, by the way. I do want to share my abiding and deep thanks to your tutors. They are an amazing bunch of people. They've shown so much care for you and your well-being and your development over the years. It hasn't only been with you, but it's also been with me. They've given me a lot of guidance, a ton of guidance, and supporting my work over the past 6 years. My huge thanks to the newbies, to Julie and to Craig, who only came on board recently in the last 12 months. Huge thank you. Up you come, Julie. Has anybody ever known Julie to be shy and retiring? To Kel, the quiet, retiring one. Joined us back in 3 years ago in year 10 and completely fitted in and very quickly became the rowdiest kid on the street. Huge thanks as well. Claire was the next one in. She started year 7, she's only young. Been with you the whole way. But for Juliet, for Brettie, for Craig and Diane. We first started teaming up back in 2012 with the class of 2014. Some of your older siblings, Jonah, Kate, Megan, Imo and Bree, were in there. One of the things that I have treasured in this time has been working with this group of people. I'm not sure you quite understand yet how fortunate you are. They're an amazing bunch. So can we please, in fact, I'm going to do something radical. On your feet, please. Standing ovation. Should we give him another round of applause? Thank you. Thank you.
You look good in red.
Okay, so this, I'm guessing, thank you very much. I'm a little overwhelmed is an understatement. It's the last opportunity potentially I'm going to have to say anything to you. It's a little bit weird after 6 years. And I am really, as I say, humbled by this occasion. So I've got three things to say. One, keep yourselves and each other safe. Please, deeply mean that. Don't want to hear of accidents. Don't want to hear of silly stuff where there hasn't been somebody looking out for somebody else. Second thing, quite a few of your tutors spoke about this. Be true to yourselves, people. Be strong. Don't let other people tell you how far you can spread your wings. As a favourite hippie writer, some of you might have read his stuff, says, argue for your limitations, and sure enough, they will be yours. Don't let anybody limit you. And finally, in the words of famous Irish prayer, may the road rise to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face. The rain fall soft upon your fields. Until we meet again, may God hold you in the palm of her hand. Guys, thank you so much. Over to Mr. Doyle to explain what is going to happen now. We have a special escort outside.
Sorry, Kyle. Good work. All right, Mr. Clippins, amazing job, everyone here today. When you are ready, it's time for the Guard of Honour.
Survive it out there, can we make it somehow? I guess I thought that this would never